Daniel.
Yes, I'm ready.
Please begin.
Okay. I'm going to, can I share the screen?
Yes.
Okay. So how do I do that? Why doesn't share? Okay, I can share, right. History is a nightmare from which I am trying to awake, said James Joyce. But how will we awake from the nightmare of representation? Why is it that as we are being pulled out of the three-dimensional world of teaspoons and sausages, pavements and elevators, and plunged into the flat topology of the Zoom screen, we are still fascinated with representation as the sine qua non of the image? Perhaps the image fascinates us not because it functions as a window onto a pre-given reality, was it ever that, but because it establishes the multiversal, an assemblage of cohesive fragments that we can codename zero, plus repetition that we can codename one, that when taken together as zero plus one, as the binary pair, form a picture of what it means to be in the digital age without lapsing into the patriarchal politics of identity and subject-object dualisms. This fascination appears to be its defining quality, because the image names not another visual form, but a new way to inhabit materiality and its relation to bodies, machines, and brains as an immersive economy. Within this always on and everywhere at the same time materiality, the world does not come before the image. Rather, the image is the visual figuration of a new layer of consciousness in which new relationship to space and time, and therefore new categories of thought, play, art, sex, and agency are emerging. The information age is characterized by a new kid on the block, by a new kind of machine, one that replicates the activities and the processes not of the body, but of the brain. Just as during the previous industrial age, machines replaced labor, the new machines, computers, replaced and human logic. And just as the industrial age configured society by mass production, mass media, and nationalism, so the computer age reconfigures society by implanting on it elements of computational logic, such as multiplicity, simultaneity, self-replication, and undecidability. The fascination with the image is due to the way it allows us to explore these qualities of information society as figured by the mechanically produced and computationally distributed picture. It is because of its link with algorithmic processing and digital technology that photography is the name of this part human, part mechanistic visual logic that abandons the familiar distinctions between truth, fiction, and fantasy. Not because these distinctions are false, but because they simply are unable to account for a form of knowledge that does not get its bearings from representation, also known as truth, index, realism, Zionism, and objectivity. Instead, photography articulates something much more serious and less sterile, such as libidinal desire and imagination articulated by digital code triggered by quantum particles as they light diodes on the computer screen while simultaneously simulating synapses to fire electrons in the brain. This new form of logic, known as fuzzy or fizzy, breaks down the boundaries between human thinking and machine intelligence and suggests that what we quaintly refer to as the real world is nothing more than so much information plucked out of chaos, the accidental conflation of bits of matter, strands of DNA, and subatomic particles. In photography, as it appears on our retina displays, one can glimpse how such improbable accidental meetings of human vision and desire with packets of data and machine language are capable of producing meaningful assemblages. The people who produce them stage deliberate interventions into the chaos that envelops us, otherwise known as nature. They play with bits of matter and bits of data until they achieve something that coheres as meaningful. In so doing, these people, also known as artists, sometimes succeed in showing the rest of us how meaning in general is being produced. The task of the artist is therefore inseparable from the task of photography. Thank you.